sahabat-sahabat Ngopi with Mili. Hari ini hari yang khusus, saya berada di Bali, di Seminyak tepatnya, dan lebih tepatnya lagi di dalam restoran Mauri. Restoran Mauri ini adalah restoran yang berhasil melalui pandemi, masa-masa yang begitu sulit, tapi mereka tetap bisa beroperasi, dan bukan hanya tetap bisa beroperasi, tetapi setiap malamnya selalu full. Hari ini saya berkesempatan untuk bertemu dengan pemilik restorannya yang sekaligus juga chefnya, yaitu Chef Maurizio, dan saya akan bertanya-tanya apa sih sebetulnya rahasia suksesnya. Dan saya dengar-dengar sang chef ini sangat mencintai Indonesia dan Bali khususnya. Kita tanya-tanya ya, kita gali-gali mengapa dan apa rahasia dari restoran ini dan rahasia resep dari kesuksesannya. Yuk kita nonton. Sahabat-sahabat Mili, saya hari ini sedang berada di Bali dan bangga sekali nih mendapatkan satu apron yang berjudul Mauri, karena saya sekarang berada di sebelah dari Chef Maurizio di restoran Mauri di Seminyak. Dan ini adalah salah satu dari restoran yang paling sukses di sini, paling rame, dan makanannya yang paling mantep. Makanannya makanan Itali. Dan kebetulan saya sedang berada bersama chefnya ini, dan chefnya ini bersedia dan mau nunjukin kepada sahabat-sahabat Mili apa aja sih makanan-makanannya yang paling terkenal, yang paling dicari-cari orang. Dan later on saya juga mau diajarin masak tiramisu. Yuk kita lihat, kita gali-gali. Hai chef, how are you? Salam sehat, we call it.
Nice to meet you.
Yeah, I understand you are from Puglia.
Yes.
Yeah, can you tell us a little bit the kind of cuisine from Puglia, Italia, South Italia?
Yeah. So the South Italian cuisine, my more Puglia cuisine, it reflects a lot of fish, seafood, fresh vegetable, a little bit of meat, not a lot, but it's more focused on fish and seafood. And that is a little bit the same what we try to bring to Mauri. It's the concept of Mauri is to bring the Puglia to Bali in a modern way, a little bit more contemporary. So we still want, when the guests eating our food, they feel the taste of Italy or the taste of Puglia, but we create in a modern way, more decorated, the nice chinaware, you know, so just look a little bit more modern. So it's not more like, you know, mama style, it's a little bit more contemporary.
Yeah. So the food basically from Puglia, you are focusing on the main ingredients. Everything have to be fresh, but it's simple and it is done in contemporary ways.
Exactly. For us, the main goal is always, you know, simple but strong on quality. The quality has to be there all the time. So we always focus on quality. So we work with a farmer from Bali, we work for fishermen from Lombok, from Bali, to get the fresh fish all the time. So that is our goal, actually, it's the quality. That's the reason why also during the pandemic still people trust us, because they know the quality is going to be there.
So I was here like 1 month ago,
yeah.
And I was presented with sort of like an omakase dishes, and I enjoyed it very well. And I would like you to explain to the audience what sort of dishes you prepare every night for the diners.
Yeah. So in our, what we always recommend to our customer the first time they dine in Mauri, we always recommend to try our signature tasting menu. Our signature tasting menu are all our classic dishes that represent Mauri style, that represent Puglia.
Yeah.
So we have different kind of amuse bouche, like the welcome bread that is focaccia with mortadella, taralli. Exactly the same like in Puglia, when you arrive to the restaurant, you always have focaccia, taralli, this kind of snack to say welcome, to say hi. And we do exactly the same here. And then it starts with the tuna with the burrata, also very important element. Tuna roll with the burrata is something typical in my place. Then we have some ravioli with Parmesan cheese. Then we have merluzzo, that is cold fish with pizzaiola sauce. And we finish with tiramisu. Why tiramisu? Tiramisu is not from Puglia, but tiramisu is an icon of dessert of Italy.
Yes.
But we create our own style.
Yes, yes. And you are going to teach me.
Of course.
How to make tiramisu.
Of course.
Yes.
Of course.
Jadi di restoran Mauri ini yang khusus adalah kita nggak usah bingung-bingung mencari. Kadang-kadang kan kita harus tanya-tanya makanan apa sih yang spesial, apa sih yang mesti dipesan. Di sini nggak usah, karena begitu kita duduk, kita langsung didatangi dan ditanya welcome, dan diberikan warm welcome, dan diberikan focaccia, lalu ada snack-snack kecil-kecil, lalu setelah kita sudah mulai merasa nyaman, lalu mulailah makanan-makanan ini berdatangan gitu. Terus can you show the audience?
Yeah. So
now,
example, the first thing what we do when you arrive to our restaurant, we're gonna serve you our rosemary cracker, our tarali. Tarali is very typical in my place, in Puglia.
I love that, yes.
And it's actually very simple to do because it's only flour and then water, a little bit of white wine, and then fennel seed. Mm-hmm. So very nice. And then it's our focaccia, that's also very typical. This is focaccia from Puglia. Why focaccia from Puglia? Because focaccia in different parts of Italy has no tomato, maybe only the bread, let's say. But in Puglia we have tomato, and then it's a little bit more flat compared to the focaccia from Tuscany or from other places of Italy. And then we topping with a little bit of mortadella, also very important for us, the mortadella. It's typical to go with the focaccia. So that is our welcome bread as soon as you arrive to Mauri, and it's to say hi.
Hello.
Welcome to Mauri. Welcome to Italy, welcome to Puglia. That's the reason behind all. And then we move to something a little bit more, let's say, more modern. I love this. This dish I created a long time ago when I first arrived to Bali. I wanted to give a cocktail to our guests, and then I realized something, that a cocktail that you can eat. So it's a spherification, in this case, of Bloody Mary. So we do.
I remember this.
Yeah, we do the Bloody Mary, and then we spherificate. And it's also another dish that we like to do because we want to tell the guests, okay, focus on our dinner, because now it's gonna be interesting, your experience. So we serve this Bloody Mary that is quite interesting, and then it will pop up in your mouth.
Yes, I remember this. Very delicious.
And then one of our other signature amuse-bouche is always our egg custard with Parmesan foam. I'm gonna So this is our Parmesan custard with our Parmesan foam. It's one of our amuse-bouche also. Our beef tartare. So we pop up the the beef tartare with caviar. That is one of our amuse-bouche.
So hot. So many amuse-bouche.
Yeah, we love that. We love to share appetizer. What we do, we cut very lightly from both sides.
Nice cutting, eh?
Yes, so we do this, we actually follow a little bit the Japanese style, you know, when they do sashimi with the cutted fish. And in my place, in Puglia, we eat a lot of raw fish, like in Japan. So many times our customers, they say, oh, why this restaurant serve raw fish? You are not a Japanese restaurant. I say, yes, in my place, in Puglia, is one of the only region in Italy where we eat everything, all the seafood raw. So this we call tagliatelle, of cuttlefish.
Tagliatelle.
Yeah, because it look like tagliatelle, but it's only fish. There is no bone and pasta. So what we gonna do? We're gonna season in the cuttlefish with olive oil, salt and pepperoni. So we always keep a very simple in seasoning. We don't put no herbs, nothing. We leave the product to talk.
Yeah, that's important.
This cuttlefish, when come, it's big like this. It's coming from Lombok, sometimes also from Bali. It's 4-5 kilo. It's a very big look.
Yeah.
Look like almost a monster. So again, it's a lot of this item. They are traditional for my place. The burrata is very famous in Puglia. The burrata is made in Puglia. Originally in Italy, the burrata come from Puglia. This burrata is made in Bali from an Italian guy. The quality is very, very good. The milk is coming from Java. We've been collaborating together since almost 7 or 8 years. All my suppliers, we've been collaborating together almost 8 to 10 years.
Then you have steady supplies.
Yes.
And you know the quality.
That's very important for our job. Green pea puree, green pea and zucchini. Green pea is very popular in Puglia, a lot, everywhere.
Really?
Actually, when I was kid, that was my favorite dish. Green pea with pasta.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Most Indonesians, we also love our greens.
70%, almost 80% of our ingredient Indonesian sauce. The only things that import from our restaurant is the Wagyu beef that's come from Australia. We have codfish that's come from Atlantic. And Parmesan cheese, the olive oil, that's come from Italy. But the rest of the item are most local. We try to work with our farmer as much as possible. And I have a new project of my own farm.
Really?
I just started.
Where?
This is very new. It's very new. We found some land in Bedugul area. And then one land also in Kerobokan, because we have new technique to do 100% organic. Not going under in the land, not going in the soil, but up. So we're gonna create a bag, we're gonna create some container where we're gonna put fresh and clean soil that we grow on the fresh and clean soil. We don't want to touch the
original soil.
Yeah, because we don't know what's happening. To make organic 100%.
I see. Wow.
This is a dream I had since long time, so finally it starts to come true. Mm-hmm. When I work in a Ritz-Carlton in Ubud, I had my own farm also, small one.
I know you used to work in Ritz-Carlton and also in Mandapa.
Yes.
And Bulgari.
And Bulgari. So we seasoning with only salt, pepper, olive oil, and then we're gonna start with our dishes. So a little bit of green pea puree, and then a little bit of green pea water, because we like to give some texture also. So in general, cheese, it doesn't go well with fish. But for burrata is different case. Burrata, it's very light, it's very creamy. So it will work with fish. But if I was doing Parmesan cheese with fish, it will destroy the dish.
Yes, overpowering.
Overpowering. That is our cuttlefish.
Beautiful.
We take the squidding from the cuttlefish and then we...
You dry it?
We dry it and then we finish on the top. Forget that it's a cuttlefish.
Yes. So the accent.
Yes. This is one of the. So it's very simple actually.
Beautiful, yeah. Can I try this?
Yes, of course.
Okay, let's try this. Cuttlefish with green peas.
Green pea and burrata.
And burrata. Okay. Let's begin, yeah? So fresh, so light, and nobody is overpowering anybody.
That's very good. Yeah.
Very balanced. Yeah. Lembut sekali. Jadi cuttlefish itu adalah seperti semacam cumi-cumi yang digunakan dicampur dengan keju burrata dan green peas, pea hijau. Semuanya sangat smooth dan sangat balanced dan tidak ada yang satu sama lain overpowering rasanya ya, jadi elegan sekali.
Yeah. You don't feel the fish, ya? You don't feel the fish.
Yeah. Sama sekali tidak fishy, sama sekali tidak amis.
most of the time I explain to our customers and they say, we don't like raw fish. And I say, you have to try. After they try, they go in love with it.
Yes. Very good.
Thank you.